Welcome to my peeps. This video is going to be a quick tutorial on how to make your own crochet case for your P1 and P2 or re-releases. So we're basically going to go over that. I'm doing a voiceover just so you know, because there was construction happening. But you're going to have a F hook here, 3.25 millimeter. This is from Clover. You're also going to need a pair of scissors to cut your yarn off when you're finished. And then as well as you're going to need stitch markers to make sure that you know your rounds when you're actually working in the round, because that's what we're going to be doing. A darning needle to weave in your ends. And then also your choice of yarn. I'm using this lilac lavender color. You know me, loving my purple. Enough of it and everything to actually work on the project. So let's get into this. Okay, so grab enough yarn that you're going to need from your spool of yarn. I usually try to get at least probably like 2 yards out before I even start, just so I have enough and I don't have to keep on tugging. And then we're going to be doing a slip knot. You can also look on YouTube tutorials on how to make slip knots. They're very simple to do. I just have a tendency of like forgetting. So YouTube is a resource for that. Get your crochet hook and then put that through the loop and fasten. This is basically the start of our yarn. We're going to be now doing a faux magic circle, which I'm going to chain 2. 1 and 2. And then in the second chain from the hook, the one below, we're going to put 6 single crochets into that. So 1 and then 2. Six for the last one. Here we're going to be doing increases. So make sure that you have 6 stitches all the way around. And then the first one we're going to do a single crochet. And you can also look those up on YouTube as well to understand what a single crochet is. So you put your yarn through, yarn over, pull through. You have 2 loops on the hook, yarn over again, pull both 2. Now we're going to get our stitch marker and put it in that first stitch to mark the beginning of our round. And then in every stitch around, we're going to be putting 2 single crochets into each stitch for an increase. So that's 2. Next stitch, we're going to do a 2 single crochet. 1, 2, in that same stitch, yarn over, go through 2 loops. And in the next stitch, do 2 single crochets again. 1, another one, 2 in the same stitch. Next, another 2 single crochets in the same stitch. 1, 2. Next stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. 1 and 2. And then 1 and 2. Now you should have 12 stitches around because we've increased by 2. We're going to then take the stitch marker out to start the next round. We're going to do a single crochet into the first stitch. This is going to be an increase as well. So 1 single crochet, put our stitch marker right back in to remember our beginning of the round. And then the next stitch, we're going to be doing 2 single crochets into the same stitch. So it's going to be 1, 2, 2, or 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2. So there's the second stitch into the. So in the next stitch, we're going to be doing single crochet, and then the next stitch, two single crochets in the same stitch, all the way around. So one, one, and then two into the same stitch. So one single crochet into the first stitch, next stitch, two single crochets into the same stitch. We're going to be increasing for another, this round and another round. So one single crochet into the first stitch, next stitch, two single crochets into the same stitch. Next stitch, one single crochet, second stitch, two single crochets into the same stitch. One and then two. Next stitch, one single crochet, second stitch, two single crochets into that same stitch. One and then two. And then we begin our third round. Take as much yarn as you can out so that you have enough. I'm pulling it off here to see how more I have to increase before it's at that edge of the Tamagotchi. Having a Tamagotchi with you will be helpful so that you know exactly where you need to be in your increases and then when you start making the body. So we're gonna put the hook right back onto the yarn, take out our stitch marker, and then we're gonna do a single crochet into the first stitch, the second stitch, and then the third stitch we're gonna put two single crochets. So one single crochet in the first stitch, don't forget your stitch marker there to mark your beginning of your and ending of your round. So one, next stitch, two single crochet, and then the third stitch, two single crochets into that same stitch. One and then two. Next stitch, one single crochet. Second stitch, one single crochet. Third stitch, two single crochets into that same stitch. Next stitch, one single crochet. Second stitch, one single crochet. Third stitch, two single crochets into that same stitch. Next, one single crochet, second stitch, one single crochet, third stitch, two single crochets into that same stitch. And just keep on doing that pattern, one, one, two in the same stitch, one, one, two in the same stitch, all the way around. And this is another increase round, so it shows basically near this end and everything where you're at in the progress of how far you have to be on the edge of your Tamagotchi. Last two stitches in that last stitch. We're gonna pull the yarn out a little bit, make sure we don't lose that tension, and then now you see it's at that very edge of your Tamagotchi now. So you know here that we're done with our increases, so now that the only we need to do is just do single crochets all the way around, just making sure the size is correct. Okay, put your hook back onto your yarn. Now we're going to take the stitch marker out and do a single crochet into that first stitch. Put your stitch marker back in to mark your rounds. Let's begin. Okay, so every stitch around, there's no more increases, so you're going to be doing a single crochet into every stitch around. So single crochet, single crochet, single crochet, all the way around. At this point, because we've done our increases, now that we stopped doing increases, it's not going to get any bigger. It's going to just stay at that size. But now that we have that set, we can now start being able to go upward, and you'll see here in a second when I get the Tamagotchi in there, it starts wrapping around the Tamagotchi so that you can be able to basically have it more secure around it. So yes, just one single crochet all the way around. And a lot of it's very much like touch and go. So whenever you have your Tamagotchi with you, it makes it easier for you to gauge how far you have to go and how less you need to do, or if you have to do it undo here and there just to get the exact size and count. So we're near an end of this round, last single crochet. Okay, so pull the yarn out to make sure it doesn't unravel. Get your Tamagotchi. And now you start seeing it starting to become a little of a bowl shape, and it's starting to go around your Tamagotchi. So we're going to do one more round of single crochets to just get it to that very edge of where the keychain and ring is at. So we're going to do another round of single crochets. Put your stitch marker right back in there. And then we're going to do single crochets all the way around again. All the way around. This becomes a little bit of the easier part because it's more of a repetitive thing. So single crochets into each stitch around. Nothing too crazy. And when we get to the ring and the chain for the keychain, we're going to do a simple method to making it so that it has a little opening for that ring and chain. So yes, just do the single crochets all the way around. And yet again, it's starting to become that little bowl type of shape to it. Just grab as much yarn as you can to make sure that you have enough to work each round. And yet again, if you're not familiar with certain verbiage and everything, whatever I've said in the video, you can look it up on YouTube, and there's quite a bit of tutorials on how to do different stitches and knots and everything. So we're back here at the beginning. Okay, so we're gonna grab our Tamagotchi, see if we're at that edge where the chain is at, and it's bowling around it, so that's really good and secure. Now that we're at the chain and the ring, we now need to accommodate for that. So, you can't really see there, but grab your crochet hook, and then here, we're gonna keep the stitch marker there, but then we're going to chain three, one, two, and then three. We're gonna keep our stitch marker there, but we're gonna count three. One, two, three. And then the third stitch, we're going to do a slip stitch into that stitch. You just basically pull it up and go through that first chain, that third chain that you created. That's going to create that little opening that we need for our chain and our ring. And then we're going to do single crochets all the way around back to the beginning. So basically that slip stitch secures our chain down so that doesn't move. And you have that opening there for your Tamagotchi's ring and chain to go through. And then doing the single crochets all the way around makes it sure that it lays flat. That way it doesn't bulge out and everything. So we're going to do single crochets all the way around again. It does become a little tedious, but you'll have a cool case for your P1 and P2. And it's going to look pretty. So we only have a few more rounds here before we're complete. But that is very much definitely an important step you have to make to accommodate for the chain and the ring. So we're going to go all the way around. We get to the very end again. And then what we're going to do now is pull up on the yarn. Oops, make sure you get that. There you go. And then we're going to get your Tamagotchi, and then we're going to get the chain and the ring through that loop just to make for sure that we have enough room to accommodate for both of those. Okay, there we go. So we start to see the shape of it come to, and it feels comfortable enough and it's not snagging, we should look good. Okay. So it's bowling around really nicely. So what we're going to do is another single round, a round of single crochets. And then we're also going to do a round of slip stitches to get that nice edge. So here we go again. We're going to put the chain back, or the hook on the crochet, or the hook onto the yarn. Now that we're back at the beginning, we can take out, we're going to basically go into that top chain again of our round that we did of the single crochet underneath where the ring is, take it out, the stitch marker, and bring it back to the top. That way we know what round we're in. And then we're gonna go do single crochets all the way around, yet again, just to get more body to that Tamagotchi that we're gonna have in it. So make sure you go through, just make sure you go through each stitch around. It gets a little tight around here, so you have to loosen up a little bit. Now I've crocheted for quite some time, so my tension is at a certain point where sometimes I can be a little too tight with my pulls. But here we are, we're doing just single crochets all the way around. All the way around. Yeah, tension is very much key when you first start crocheting. If you do it too tight, it can wear out your hand, and then your project can be not as fitted. But I've crocheted for so long that I know certain bits of my tension. Only here and there does my tension get too tight. With something like this, you would want it to be tight enough so that it fits around your Tamagotchi and secures it, so it doesn't get dinged up or break. So we're getting back to the beginning again, where our stitch marker is at. Okay, pull it up a little bit. Yet again, it's going back and forth with your Tamagotchi and with your yarn work, just to see if the sizing is correct and everything. So that opening is a little bit more secure now, has a little more of a doorway. You get your chain and your ring through it, and now it's starting to shape itself around your Tamagotchi, like completely. So it's a little bit more secure. So the next round, I would believe, is where we are now going to be doing slip stitches, and then we finish off our project and we're good to go. So hook back on the yarn. We're going to take our stitch marker out. Put a hook back through that stitch. And then do a slip stitch. You can look up slip stitches as well on YouTube. But basically, you look like you're about to do a single crochet, yarn over, pull through. And instead of yarn over again, you just pull that stitch through your initial stitch. Here, you'll see it again. Instead of like finishing it off, you can just grab it, pull it up a little bit, put it underneath the other one. Grab some yarn, pull it up a little bit, go underneath that stitch. There you go. Very, very simple. And this is gonna create a little bit of a trim to the top of the Tamagotchi. That way it's sort of like encases over it just a little bit more, and it looks a little bit cleaner. So yes, then basically this last round, you're gonna be doing slip stitches to get that edge that you're wanting. I love crocheting. This is another reason why I love it, because I can make these for my little virtual pets. They're awesome. So yeah, then you just do it all the way around, slip stitches all the way around that edge. You see how I'm pulling up on the yarn a little bit so it's not too tight. Pull through. All the way around to back to the stitch marker. Yet again, it's all about the tension that you have there. There we go. We're gonna pull it up a little bit. Take our stitch marker out. get a Tamagotchi once more to see if everything is looking good and neat. And there you go. See, now it's like a little bit more cradled around it, and we are good. So now this portion, we are going to weave in our ends. So we're gonna make for sure everything is weaved in so that we don't have to worry about things coming unloose. So we're gonna grab our scissors, cut our working yarn out. Boom. Then we're gonna get our darning needle after we get the Tamagotchi out. So we're gonna take that yarn through, make it like a little bit of a knot there. Take the Tamagotchi out, get my darning needle, and we're gonna weave in our ends. We're gonna go at the very last bit of our yarn, take it through the eye of that darning needle, thread it through, and then we're going to grab the yarn and go on the adjacent side of where the stitch marker was, and then pull slightly so it makes it even. And then we're gonna weave in the ends downward near this, like basically, well, go through a little bit through the top to secure it to make it even. And then we will then go through the actual case downward in a spiral almost. Basically, you can do it however you want, but I think if this makes it look a little bit neater. And then you pull it inside out and then cut off the excess. And then you have a little bit of yarn as well from when you did your first circle. You pull that through a little bit, pull it back inside out, get your darning needle again, and you're gonna weave in that a little bit as well just to give it a little bit of a neatness to it. Put it through the eye of that needle. And then you're gonna weave in that end to tug in a little bit, go through, pull it inside out again, put it back on the needle. You're just gonna do that a few more times, how much ever you feel that you need. It's not too tight because you don't want it to start pulling in on the seams, but just enough so that it looks cohesive and neat. And then you pull it through again, cut off the excess, boom, whoop. And now you've got your own custom Tamagotchi case for your P1 and P2 or the re-releases. So grab your Tamagotchi, put it through the chain and the ring through the top enclosure, move it around a little bit, make it feel comfortable, and bam, there you go. Your own custom case for your Tamagotchi crochet case. I hope you guys like this video. I really appreciate you guys so much for watching and asking and requesting videos and everything. I really, really appreciate it, and I hope this helpful. I love you guys so much. Comment down below if you have any questions. I would love to answer those. And then also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this content. Have a good one. Bye.